Today, we're going to talk about the recognition of ferrous objects. We will take the opportunity to clean up this pasture. The Deus II is a very open device. Few filters are activated as standard, which allows you to gain performance. It also keeps a good discrimination to easily identify ferrous targets. Large pieces of iron are often difficult to discriminate for most detectors. The Deus II has filters allowing to recognize this type of target. The sound of trash can also approach the sound of a good target under difficult conditions. That's why, unlike its competitors, XP has deactivated a maximum number of filters in its factory programs. It allows you to find good targets that only a few devices are capable of. The Deus II remains fully configurable, so you can modify different settings to help you discriminate ferrous targets. Discrimination is a very important setting for identifying ferrous objects. Your Deus II assigns an ID to all targets. It varies according to size, depth, soil and type of metal. Most ferrous have a low ID, below 10. Discrimination assigns a low tone to ferrous. This means that all TIDs below the discrimination setting will sound low. I detect with sensitive, discrimination is 6.8. It is a very open program which is efficient in all situations. Listen to this sound. It sounds medium, like a good target. Obviously, an experienced user will recognize the dubious sound that characterizes a ferrous in discrimination limit. The target ID will confirm this. These nuances are not always obvious to identify, especially without visual display. This iron has an ID of 7, all I have to do is increase the discrimination above to eliminate it with a low sound. Unlike some detectors, the discrimination on Deus II has no impact on the power of the device. We just modify the conductivity threshold at which the targets sound low. On the other hand, you should not adjust the discrimination too high, especially on mineralized and polluted terrain or for deep searches. Under these conditions, some good targets have their ID reduced. A discrimination setting too high will therefore make them sound low. In most situations, a setting between 6 and 10 will be suitable. Expert adjustment of discrimination allows you to precisely adjust the audio frequency of the low tone as well as its volume with iron volume adjustment. I advise you to always keep a minimum of iron volume to be able to identify the presence of ferrous and adapt your settings. The Goldfield and Relic programs use IAR discrimination. It also allows you to reject ferrous, but in another way. Goldfield is designed for highly mineralized terrain and Relic for deep targets. In both cases, good targets can have their conductivity reduced, and thus approach that of a ferrous target. IAR discrimination allows ferrous to be rejected according to their depth. At 0, we are in all metals mode, at 3, we reject nearby ferrous, and at 5, we reject all ferrous targets. It must be set as low as possible, but if ferrous are too present, don't hesitate to increase it to save time. Since version 1, you can adjust the maximum frequency of your Deus II. This setting has an influence on the ferrous discrimination. With a high maximum frequency, such as 40 kHz, your detector will have more difficulty discriminating ferrous objects. You'll hear more high-pitched sounds, especially on large or specially shaped ferrous objects. In return, the device will be more sensitive to small conductive targets, and better able to penetrate mineralized and polluted soils. For better recognition of ferrous, a lower maximum frequency will be more effective, and the device will be more efficient at finding good-sized targets at depth. Overall, it will be more stable on wet grounds. The maximum frequency must therefore be adapted to the terrain and your type of search. But the higher the value, the more difficult it will be to discriminate certain ferrous objects. I'm still with the sensitive program which has a maximum frequency of 40 kHz. Now let's lower the frequency max. I switch it to 24 kHz. We can already hear a difference. The sound is more doubtful and it's easier to identify the ferrous. Now let's move on to 14 kHz. The sound is now very saturated, and we can even hear low tones. We can recognize the ferrous very easily. The low maximum frequency allows better recognition of ferrous. We have a well-oxidized piece of spoon. We now turn to the two filters offered by Deus 2 to improve discrimination. Some specific ferrous are more complicated to discriminate. The silencer setting suppresses the high-pitched sounds produced by some ions. It gives you a clearer low sound and makes it easy to recognize ions. We'll therefore gain in detection comfort. It is always preferable to use the silencer on non-mineralized soils, and preferably with a low setting. Setting 2 or 3 will be a good compromise. On mineralized grounds, it's better to keep a setting of 1 or even 0 to optimize performance and avoid degrading certain signals. I'm still with the sensitive program, with the silencer at 1. We have a medium sound with some low tones that alert us to the possible presence of a ferrous. I increase it to 2. With the setting at 2, the sound cuts off and you hear low tones. Setting to 5. With the setting at 5, you only hear a low tone. We have a wrought iron, therefore difficult to discriminate. The second filter that can be used in addition to silencer is the B-caps. Originally designed for highly effective removal of ferrous capsules, it is equally effective on specific ferrous such as rings, cartridges and certain large forged irons. This is the perfect target for testing B-caps. I use the sensitive program. B-caps is disabled. We have a slightly saturated sound with a conductivity of 70. Let's try increasing the B-cap setting. I change it to 1. We're already starting to see a difference. The sound is degraded. Let's move it to 2. We have low tones that alert us to the presence of ferrous. With the setting at 4, we only have a low tone. No more doubt about the presence of ferrous. We do have a ferrous metal, it's a piece of horseshoe. Once again, a large wrought iron piece that's hard to discriminate. In short, if you detect in simple conditions with non-mineralized soil, good-sized targets and not too deep, we can choose uncompromising detection comfort. We will adjust the discrimination according to the ferrous present in the area. We can use a maximum frequency average or even low depending on targets we are looking for. And if some ions are difficult to discriminate, you can use the silencer or the B-caps filter. When searching for very small targets in complicated, mineralized or highly polluted terrain, the conditions will require us to use low discrimination to avoid making small, deep targets sound low. We will use the maximum frequency of 40 kHz to maximize the performance on this type of search. The B-caps filter must be deactivated and the silencer set to 1 or even 0 to avoid degrading the signal in complicated conditions. With this type of setting, the Deus 2 is excellent on difficult terrain, but you'll have to recognize the ferrous by analyzing the subtleties and nuances of the different sounds. It takes a little time to get used to, but with a little practice, you'll be able to recognize them without difficulty. I'm going to show you a few tips that make ferrous analysis easier. First of all, it's possible to recognize most ferrous on the first pass of the coil, without even stopping on it. It's all about the nuances of sound. The Deus 2 is extremely rich in audio. For the same tone, it has many harmonic variations. Here I have a good target and a ferrous that is complicated to discriminate. I use original sensitive program. Listen to the difference between the two sounds. At the first coil pass, you can identify the ferrous which have a saturated, abrupt and clipped sound. Conversely, the correct target gives a more pleasant, softer and more progressive sound. With a little practice, you will therefore be able to pass this type of ferrous without even stopping. Conversely, the sweet sound of the good target will call out to you. If in doubt, we'll spend more time analyzing the target. It's better to waste a few seconds listening a signal than several minutes digging a deep iron. First of all, we turn around the target. If the signal is unstable or if we hear low tones, there are great chances whether it is ferrous. no more doubt, it's definitely a ferrus. Conversely, if the sound is stable and precise, it indicates a good target. We can then circumscribe the target. Complex ferrus are very often large. If, in addition, a low sound is heard when the coil is swept along the edge of the target, it's probably a ferrus object. In this case, we can see that the target is large. In addition, when sweeping at the limit of target, a low sound appears. We are indeed in the presence of a ferrus. On the good target, there is no low tone at the target limit. Another technique is to raise the coil. It gives you an idea of the size and the depth of the target. In some cases, a large shallow ferrus will give a low sound. By analyzing a dubious target in this way, you can easily identify ferrous objects. If doubt persists, dig. We sometimes have nice surprises. Personally, I like detecting this way for all searches and on all types of terrain. I lose a little in detection comfort, but I'm sure I'll have a very open device that won't let any target through in difficult conditions. If you can recognize ferrous without using filters, you might as well do without them. If you've had your dais for a short time and are still learning, I advise you to dig as many sounds as possible, even when they are dubious. This will enable you to identify nuances of sound, corresponding to different targets. You'll get used to recognizing waste more easily. Don't forget that successful recognition of ferrous waste is good, but digging it up and cleaning it up when possible is even better. In addition, not all large irons are waste. Good detection and cleanup for all.